Here we are in the Rhode Show Kitchen. Chef Derek Woods here from Pizza J. That's the location. Now, we're going to make two pizzas today. Tony Clifton and the beautiful Yeti is what we're making. Good morning. Nice to have you here.
Great to have you.
Nice to have you here in our Rhode Show Kitchen this morning. We all love pizza. You guys just opened recently, right?
Correct. About 3 months ago.
Okay.
And business is starting to really pick up, and we're open 7 days a week.
Okay, so it is
all day long from 11 to 11, and then we close at 12 o'clock midnight on Fridays and Saturdays.
All right, so talk to me about the pizza that you guys make. Obviously, you're part of Julian's too, so you really have like some new creative ways to put this together, correct?
Of course, all of our bread is made in-house. Dough. We make a cauliflower crust for mm-hmm. gluten-free option. We also make vegan cheese out of cashews, which can be substituted for any pizza that we have at the restaurant.
And the flavor's still there. It still tastes good.
It's just the same.
Just the same. Okay, so we're going to make two pizzas today. Let's go over the ingredients that we need to put these together.
Alrighty. So for the Tony Clifton, it starts with blanched potatoes, mm-hmm. fire-roasted red peppers, red onions, and we have a seasoned herbed whipped ricotta cheese that goes down, and it creates kind of a white sauce along with our house blend of hand-shredded cheeses.
Right.
And then the beautiful Yeti, it is a...
I love it, by the way.
It is a smoked, slow-roasted pork shoulder.
Nice.
And that takes about anywhere for 13 hours just to prep for this one dish.
Okay.
Then we make a whiskey cola barbecue sauce that goes along with it, and then it's dressed with red onions and fresh scallions.
You are making dreams come true here tonight. Everybody's going to be happy. All right, we're going to put these two pizzas together, talk about the restaurant just a little bit. Back to you.
Michaela's with Pizza J.
Yeah, that's right, Chef. Derek is here from Pizza J, and, well, we've got pizza on the menu, because if you didn't, I'd kick you out.
All right.
We love pizza here, though, and I want to talk about this one that we're making. First of all, the crust looks a bit different than what we're used to when we're making pizza.
All of the pies are hand-formed, and they're all square.
Okay.
Classic Italian style, as our boss says.
Beautiful. You've prepped this a little bit already.
Correct. This is a house blend of mozzarella and cheddar, mm-hmm. and then we have an herb whipped ricotta cheese that kind of melts in with the other cheeses and creates a white sauce.
That sounds delicious. And you've put it in a little like piping bag here to make it easier.
Oh yeah, that is the easiest way to do it.
Okay, now where do we stand? What do we need to top this with?
We're gonna start with some blanched potatoes.
Okay.
Which are right here.
And the name of this pizza is what?
This is the Tony Clifton.
The Tony Clifton.
And Tony Clifton was Andy Kaufman's alter ego. I don't know if we're hip to that. So it's these blanched potatoes. We're mm-hmm. doing roasted red peppers as well.
Okay.
A little bit of elephant garlic, which you got right underneath the potatoes.
Okay, yeah, you go ahead. Grab some ingredients, too. We'll do it together.
Oh, sounds good.
Now, about how many pizzas are you guys making a night?
Anywhere from 90 to about 150.
Yowza. It's incredible. And how many are on the menu?
7 to 8. Regular pies, mm-hmm. Or we call them specialty pies, and then we have a DIY menu where you can literally build your own pizza out of any ingredient that we have in the restaurant.
That sounds incredible.
We also have gluten-free options where we do our cauliflower crust, uh-huh. and we make cheese from cashews for vegans.
Wow, so you really are catering to everyone. I mean, you're not leaving anybody out.
No, ma'am.
Get that. We're going to sprinkle these on there.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so we've got the potatoes. We've got, what did you call this, elephant garlic?
That's elephant garlic.
Okay.
It's and a little bit more it's a little bit more mild than a normal garlic.
Roasted peppers there. Anything mm-hmm. else that goes on this one?
We're going to finish it with these nice shaved red onion.
Shaved red onion. And then we'll pop it in the oven?
Yes.
Time and temp there, chef.
Preferably we want it as hot as possible. So okay. 500 is going to have to do.
And I'm sure I was going to say onions. I'm sprinkling the onions. Your ovens at the place are a lot hotter than that.
Our brick oven maintains at 800 degrees.
Wow. Okay. Well, that means you're just going to get your pizza out very quickly.
Indeed.
All right. Stick around because we've got more pizza to make when we come back.
If you like pizza, you've come to the right place. Chef Derek Woods here. Pizza J is the place. We've got two pizzas. Tony Clifton and the beautiful Yeti. That's what we're making today.
Yes, indeed.
He's got the dough. He's ready to go.
That dough looks great.
What kind
is that?
This is all homemade, mm-hmm. and it's a little bit of wheat flour, and that adds a real nice texture, and it keeps it nice and fluffy.
Okay.
Wow, you're stretching that out there.
Oh, yeah. All of our pizzas, every single one, handmade, hand-stretched, to order. Nothing's pre-made.
That's beautiful.
So when you get it, fresh.
as fresh as gets. There we go. So once we shape it into a nice little square on our board, we'll cheese
and
it
no
up.
No holes.
No holes.
Impressive.
I did all right.
Clearly, he's been doing this for a while.
You get to make more pizza tonight.
So we're gonna cheese this up, and then this beautiful Yeti pizza we have. This is with our smoked, slow roasted pork shoulder.
Yum.
It also gets a whiskey cola barbecue sauce that we make in house.
Sounds good.
And it is my favorite thing in the whole wide world.
Now, who's in charge of naming these pizzas? Because we just made the Tony Clifton, and now it's the beautiful Yeti.
Julian comes up with most of them, but it's a kind of a joint effort. The beautiful Yeti was named after one of our cooks, who was a beautiful Yeti. So here's our
nice,
slow roasted pork shoulder.
And you said what, it takes about 13 hours or more
just
for this?
Just about, yes.
So it's really tender, falls apart.
Oh, yeah. It doesn't take much.
You really don't skimp on ingredients here. Just the amount of them on each piece that you're going to have, and the quality, too.
I like to think that every single bite should be exactly the same.
Okay.
And from the crust all the way in, you know, that's why I actually brought extra pork, because I said it might not be enough.
Look, this won't last 5 minutes around here. It'll be gone pretty quick.
No.
Be gone very, very quick.
So, we got our pork all set up here. And now it's time for my favorite, this.
That's that homemade barbecue sauce,
homemade whiskey cola barbecue.
Yum.
It's good.
Do you have a top seller over at Pizza J?
Our cheese is fantastic.
Yeah.
That's where we started. If you can't make a good cheese pizza, then what's the point?
Yeah, you're
exactly.
Gonna put the clothes on.
Start with the basics, right?
And so here
it's a good crowd pleaser.
Exactly.
So, and anybody who loves Julian's will love this restaurant too, because this isn't your traditional kind of pizza. You guys really do it up big time.
Indeed. The theme is basically similar.
Mm-hmm.
I guess you could say you walk in and you say, okay, this is something that Julian has created.
Same vibe.
We have a secret arcade in the back with pinball machines.
Awesome.
And original four-player gauntlet, which is my kryptonite. And so here we go. We got this pizza ready, ready to fire.
Looks good.
And that goes in the oven there. You mentioned nostalgia, too, and I'm sure a lot of people have been noticing maybe some familiar toys behind us throughout the morning.
Stuff,
You get a lot of things there.
Boom.
I've been eyeing the My Little Pony. And they don't make them like that anymore.
Actually, I think I may have had this one. I think I did.
Ultraman?
Actually, this may be mine.
Is that yours?
WG on the back.
Let's see.
All right, now we...
Look at how great they
this
look.
This is the one we started before.
Mm-hmm.
And that looks so good.
The Tony Clifton, which is just going to get finished with some nice fresh herbs.
Yum.
From a local farm, Chancel Valley Farms.
Beautiful. Now, do you do anything special over at Pizza J? Are there any special nights or things that we should keep in mind?
Well, coming up on the 25th, we have a canned food drive, and it's going to be an all-you-can-eat buffet. So you bring either a winter jacket or 5 canned goods, and it's going to be all-you-can-eat.
That's great.
My gosh.
So we're going to have lasagna, meatballs, and pasta, and all that good stuff.
And all you got to do is bring a jacket or... That you can't go wrong with that. There's so many people who have jackets in their closet.
And we're going to be flinging pies out nonstop all night.
Yeah. And tell everybody where you guys are located to.
We're at 967 Westminster Street.
Okay, easy
enough. Perfect location. This smells incredible.
Should we get cutting?
Yeah, yes. Please slice
all
away.
Right. Slice away.
Because we're going to have to dive into this. And I love, you can even just tell by the crust, it's going to be so nice and crunchy
looks
when you
good.
Dive into there. All right, don't forget, if you want this recipe and the other recipe for the pizza that we made, head on over to roadshow.com.